Write the function f of x equals x squared minus 6x plus 13 in vertex form. So vertex form is like this. Where a, h, and k are all constants. So what I need to do basically is take this function and make it a perfect square. The first thing I'm going to do is subtract the constant term from both sides. So I'm going to make it f of x minus 13 equals x squared minus 6x. Just subtracted 13 from both sides. Okay, so let me recopy the original function here. Then we're going to subtract 13 from both sides. Why am I subtracting 13? Well, it's setting us up to have an easier job when we have to 13 minus 13 is 0, when we have to make the perfect square. So then what number should be here? We have x squared minus 6x. Let's just kind of ignore the f of x minus 13 for now. We have our x squared minus 6x, so we need a plus something to make a perfect square. Well, what we do is we take this middle number, which is negative 6, and we'll divide it by 2, and then square it. So negative 6 divided by 2 is negative 3. Negative 3 squared is 9. So what we need to do is we need to add 9 to make a perfect square trinomial. We'll add 9 to both sides of the equation. So we'll have f of x, and then negative 13 plus 9 is negative 4, equals x squared minus 6x plus 9. So f of x minus 4 equals, and now we use our special factoring pattern. So we have f of x minus 4 equals x minus 3 quantity squared. And this is our perfect square. So now I'm simply going to add 4 to both sides to put it back in function form. F of x equals x minus 3 quantity squared plus 4. Now this is the exact same function that we started out with. It's just written in a different form. It's in vertex form, which should really emphasize the vertex, which is 3, 4, and it'll also make it a lot easier to graph. So let's review the steps. First thing we did is we subtracted the constant term from both sides, and then we figured out what constant term we would need to make a perfect square trinomial. Then we added that term to both sides, converted our trinomial into a binomial, and then we added the constant term back to put it in function form.